Hello students, so we had a discussion on pressure, fluid pressure and fluid thrust. What is the pressure at a point inside a liquid? Pressure at a point inside a fluid, P is equal to rho into G into H. That is the pressure exerted by a liquid at a given point inside a liquid. That is called pressure at a point inside a liquid. For that, there is an atmospheric pressure is also there. Atmospheric pressure, which is exerted by the gaseous molecule on the surface of the liquid. Atmospheric pressure. So first of all, what do you mean by atmospheric pressure? Earth is surrounded by envelope of gases or air, such as oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, some traces of carbon dioxide also. On the surface of the earth, right, the density of the, near to the surface of the earth, the density of the gases is more, even some of the inert gases also there. So what is earth atmosphere? Earth atmosphere consisting of gases such as air, consisting of oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, some traces of carbon dioxide, even inert gases also. The density of gases is more near to the surface of the earth. As we move away from the surface of the earth, the density of the gases will decreases. Then what do you mean by atmospheric pressure? The pressure exerted by the gaseous molecule on the surface is what is called as atmospheric pressure. The atmospheric pressure is measured in terms of the height of the mercury level that rises in the capillary tube or that rises in the tube. So which is compensated, which is calibrated as how much of the height of the liquid, height of the mercury that is rises in the tube when you place the device called barometer on the surface of the sea level. See here, what do you mean by atmosphere? Atmosphere, as I mentioned already, earth atmosphere. The space around the earth is what is called earth atmosphere. Is consisting of a mixture of gases, oxygen, nitrogen, hydrogen, carbon dioxide, even some inert gases also. On the surface of the earth, the density of the gases is more, the density of the atmosphere is more. As you move away from the surface of the earth, the density of the gases will decreases as we move away from the earth surface. Then what do you mean by atmospheric pressure? Thrust exerted by the gaseous molecule per unit area is what is called as atmospheric pressure. So the atmospheric pressure is measured in terms of how much of the mercury level that rises in the tube when you place the tube on the and you place a device on the surface of the sea level. So what is one atmospheric pressure? Thrust exerted by the atmosphere per unit area is called atmospheric pressure. One atmospheric pressure is equal to 1.013 to 10 to the power of pi Pascal. Pascal is the S unit of pressure. The other unit of pressure, atmospheric pressure, is bar. 1 bar is equal to 10 to the power of 5 Pascal. Again, one atmospheric pressure is equal to 1.013 bar, because 1 bar is 10 to the power of 5 Pascal. So you will get 1 atmospheric pressure is equal to 1.013 into 10 to the power of 5 Pascal is, what is the value of 10 to the power of 5 Pascal? That is 1 bar. Even in vacuum technology, the unit of atmospheric pressure is bar. In vacuum technology, how much of the atmospheric pressure is created in a vacuum? Your vacuum means you are removing all the molecules present in a system. That is called vacuum. In vacuum technology, the unit of atmospheric pressure is torr. One atmospheric pressure is equal to 760 torr. So, to measure the atmospheric pressure, atmospheric pressure is measured by a device called as, what is called barometer. What do you mean by a barometer? Barometer is a device to measure the atmospheric pressure. So, you know well, the density of mercury, the liquid which is having the highest density is what is called mercury. its density is 13.68 to 10 to the power of 5, 10 to the power of 3 kg per meter cube at 0 degree centigrade. So the pressure exerted by the liquid at a given point, as you know well, which is equal to the weight of the liquid, which is equal to the, see here, rho gh. So the height of the mercury column, which is raised from the surface of the sea level. So this is equal to the atmospheric pressure. So why we required a height of the liquid level is why it is required. So how much of the pressure exerted by the gaseous molecule, which is equal to the height of the liquid, height of the mercury level that rises in the tube when you place the barometer on the surface of the sea. See here, therefore, the pressure exerted by the liquid is equal to rho gh. That is, if you calculate, you will get 1.013 into 10 to the power of 5 Pascal. You have density of the mercury, g is acceleration due to gravity, h is the height of the mercury level that rises in the glass tube. Height of the mercury level that rises in the glass tube, that is h. This is what is called the. So therefore, you can calculate directly. Atmospheric pressure is directly proportional to the height of the liquid. Atmospheric pressure is directly proportional to the height of the liquid that rises in the tube with respect to the sea level. Please copy the things, these points. The atmospheric pressure, say the density of gases, the density of air is very maximum on the surface of the earth. As you go height, the density of the gases will decrease us. As a result, atmospheric pressure will also decrease us. Then you can conclude that the atmospheric pressure is, more at the surface of the earth. The atmospheric pressure is maximum on the, at the surface of the earth. As you move away, away from the surface of the earth, the atmospheric pressure decreases as height increases. So therefore, you can conclude that atmospheric pressure is directly proportional to the height of the liquid level that rises in the glass tube. So how to measure the atmospheric pressure? Atmospheric pressure is measured by a device called barometer. Barometer is a device to measure the atmospheric pressure. So I'll move on to the, what is the construction of the barometer, right? For low, you want to measure the low density liquid. Oil is having a low density, right? You can measure the low density liquid, atmospheric pressure, pressure exerted by the low density liquid. If you want to measure the high density liquid, you have to fill the mercury is an high density liquid. So what is, first of all, construction of the barometer? Barometer is a device used to measure the pressure, atmospheric pressure. So now it consisting of, please observe the diagram. It consisting of a glass tube, right, filled with the mercury, right? The other end, one end is closed. So with the other end, which is immersed in a container, immersed in a beaker containing mercury. It consisting of a glass tube, one end is closed. To the other end, the mercury is filled. That mercury filled tube, which is immersed in the container containing mercury. So what happens here? There is a pressure exerted by the air molecules. The pressure exerted by the air molecules on the surface of the mercury present in a beaker, present in a mercury trough. This is a mercury trough. Whatever the atmospheric pressure exerted on the surface of the mercury, which is equal to the mercury level which is increases in the glass tube. So what is the analysis? The pressure, the atmospheric pressure exerted on the mercury, surface of the mercury present in a trough, which is equal to the height of the mercury column, which is balanced by the height of the mercury column. I'll repeat once again. So barometer is a device to measure the pressure, atmospheric pressure, right? So it consisting of a glass tube which is filled with mercury. So one end is closed. The inverted glass tube, which is immersed in a trough having a mercury, filled with mercury. So on the beaker or trough, the atmospheric pressure is exerted on the surface of the mercury. As a result, this whatever the atmospheric pressure exerted by the molecules on the surface of the mercury, which is equal to the height of the liquid column, which is balanced by the height of the liquid column, which is filled in the glass tube. Therefore, what is the pressure? Whatever the atmospheric pressure is there, exactly from ear to ear is 760 millimeter. The height of the liquid will be rises in the glass tube will be equal to 760 millimeter. Therefore, you can substitute here P, you know the pressure. I want to calculate the atmospheric pressure. P is equal to rho is the density of liquid. G is acceleration due to gravity at the place, and where H is the height of the mercury column. Height of the mercury column that rises in the glass tube, that is equal to the whatever the pressure exerted by the air molecules on the surface of the mercury present in the trough, which is proportional to the height of the mercury column. The height which is balanced by the height of the mercury column, the mercury column is exactly, it stands at a particular height of 760 millimeter from the surface of the mercury. So therefore, if you from this, using this formula, the pressure, the atmospheric pressure is equal to rho into g into h. Rho is the density of the liquid, g is acceleration due to gravity, and h is the height of the liquid that is rises in the glass tube. So now another one is, we have a device called open tube manometer. Open, please observe carefully. This is to measure the atmospheric pressure. This is the atmospheric pressure. You can measure like this by using this instrument, is what is called barometer. The other instrument is what is called the open tube manometer. What is this open tube manometer? To measure the pressure difference. See, what is the pressure at this point and what is the pressure at this point? To measure the pressure difference between the liquids. See here, open tube manometer. Open tube manometer is a device to measure the pressure difference. See, whatever the pressure which is to be determined, the pressure of the liquid which is to be determined is filled in this bulb, right? And the U-tube is filled with a liquid or water, right? This U-tube is filled with a liquid. The pressure of the liquid which is to be determined is filled in the bulb. Observe carefully, whatever the pressure exerted by this liquid molecule, the pressure which is to be determined, which is exerting a pressure at point A, whatever the pressure exerted by this molecule, which is proportional to the height of the liquid that rises in the tube, vertical tube. Definitely, pressure at point A is same as the pressure at point B only. Whatever the atmospheric pressure at point A is same as the atmospheric pressure at point B. What is the pressure exerted by this liquid? The pressure exerted by the unknown liquid, which is proportional to the height of the liquid level that rises in the U-tube. Open tube. This is an open tube. Therefore, you can conclude that open tube manometer is a device to measure the pressure difference. This is consider a liquid whose pressure should be determined is taken in a bulb tube, again which is interconnected to an U-tube. The U-tube is filled with some liquid or water, you can take. Definitely, the moment when you compress this one, there is a pressure exerted by the liquid at point A, as well as there is an atmospheric pressure is also acting at point A. Therefore, if you measure pressure at point A and pressure at point B, the pressure at point A is same as pressure at point B also. That is called atmospheric pressure. Whatever the excess pressure is there, the excess pressure is what is called as pressure exerted by the liquid, which is proportional to the height of the liquid that rises in the open tube. This is the pressure exerted by. Therefore, pressure point A is same as pressure point B. So, whatever the pressure exerted by this liquid, which is equal to the height of the liquid that rises in the vertical tube. Therefore, is the total pressure exerted by this liquid is equal to, and atmospheric pressure is PA. P minus PA is equal to rho GH, where rho GH is called gauge pressure. That is the pressure exerted by the liquid. So, mercury trough. So, very very important points here. Low density liquid, oil is a low density liquid, to measure low pressure differences. High density liquid, that is mercury, to measure high pressure differences. Whatever the pressure exerted by the liquid in the bulb, which is proportional to the height of the liquid that rises in the one end of the open tube. So whatever the atmospheric pressure at point A is same as the atmospheric pressure at point B. The difference between the pressure exerted by the liquid and the pressure, atmospheric pressure, will give rise to the gauge pressure. Please copy the things. PA is the atmospheric pressure exerted on the exerted by the gaseous molecule on the surface of the mercury present in a trough. Whatever the atmospheric pressure exerted on the mercury surface of the mercury present in a trough, which is proportional to the height of the mercury level, height of the mercury level that rises in the glass tube. So that is, therefore, pressure. The atmospheric pressure is directly proportional to the height of the liquid that rises in the glass tube. Here PA is equal to P, which is equal to rho GH only. In the second case is a open tube manometer. Open tube manometer is a device to measure the pressure difference. It consisting of a U-tube, which is in turn connected to a bulb. The pressure of a liquid which is to be determined is filled in a bulb tube. So now you exert a pressure on the bulb. Definitely there is a pressure exerted at the points A and B that is equal to the atmospheric pressure. The atmospheric pressure is same at point A and at point B is also. Whatever the excess pressure is applied at point P is proportional to the height of the liquid that is rises in the open tube. Therefore, that is the difference between the applied pressure and the atmospheric pressure is equal to rho GH is what is called as a gauge pressure. So, very very important is what is called Pascal's law. What do you mean by Pascal law? See here, liquids are having a highly incompressible. What do you mean by an ideal fluid? Water is an ideal fluid. Highly incompressible. If you compress the fluid, you will not get compression. So, that's called as ideal fluid. Ideal fluids are highly incompressible, non-viscous fluid and steady. They are called ideal fluid. Water is an ideal fluid. What is Pascal's law? What do you mean by Pascal's law? The law states that when a pressure is exerted at any point on the fluid, the pressure exerted by a fluid at any point, which is distributed to every portion of the fluid, which is distributed or which is transmitted to every portion of the fluid, which is undiminished, which is undiminished, is what is called as Pascal's law. Please observe the diagram. Let us consider a vessel containing water, filled with water, with four openings. Capital A, B, C, D. These are the four openings present in a vessel. Having an area of cross section A1, A2, A3, A4. And they are fitted with a pistons. I'll repeat. Let us consider a vessel filled with water with the four openings. ABCD are the four pistons. A is a piston. ABCD are the four pistons which are fixed to the vessel, fixed to the openings. And the area of cross sections of the valves A1, A2, A3, A4. A1, A2, A3, A4 are the valve areas of the area of cross section of the valves or the openings. So now you apply that F1 is the force exerted, external force is acting on the fluid at point A. You are applying a force F1 at point A. The area of the opening or area of the piston is A1. There is a pressure is created at point A, right? You are applying a force. Let F1 is the force externally. External force is acting on the piston A1, having an area A1. Definitely there is a pressure is created. The pressure is transmitted equally remaining all the B, C, D valves. So that is only the concept of Pascal law. What do you mean by Pascal law? The law states that the pressure exerted by a fluid at any point which is transmitted equally and it is undiminished to the every part of the fluid is what is called as and which is constant to the every part of the fluid and it is undiminished and it is equally is what is called as Pascal and it is remains constant. Let us consider a vessel containing water, filled with water, having four openings, and the area of cross section of the valves are openings are piston, which are fitted with a pistons. And let us A1, A2, A3, A4 are the cross sectional areas of the pistons fitted to the openings A, B, C, D respectively. Let F1 is the force, external force acting on the piston. Definitely there is a pressure is exerted by the pressure is exerted at this point. That pressure is transmitted equally at all the points which is transmitted to the all the parts of the fluid which is remains constant. So that is the principle of Pascal's law. Pascal's law states that the pressure exerted by a fluid at any point which is transmitted equally to all the parts of the fluid and it will remain constant. So this is the analysis. So definitely what is the pressure? Therefore the pressure at this point A is equal to P is equal to force F1 by A1 which remains constant. Whatever the pressure is created at point A which is distributed to all the points B, C and D respectively. Therefore observe carefully. A, B, C, D are the pistons. A1, A2, A3 and A4 are the openings and they will be areas of different cross sectional areas. If any of the pistons inward, all other pistons move outward. I am applying a force F1 to the piston A. Right? With the force F1, all other pistons are moved outward. This piston is moving outward with F2. This piston is moved outward with force F3. And this piston is moved through the force F4. So whatever the pressure is created at point A, which is distributed or transmitted to all the parts of the fluid, which will remain constant. As area increases, force will also increase. Look at carefully, area is increasing, force is increasing. So now area is still more, still force is here. Here A3 is the area, force is F3. Here area will become A4, force is F4. Therefore, force is proportional to area. As the area of cross section of the valve piston increases, the force exerted by the fluid will also increase. But pressure will remain constant. But pressure F1 by A1 is equal to, can I write here, F2 by A2 is equal to F3 by A3 will remain constant. Therefore, what can I write here? If any of the pistons say A is pressed inward, I am applying a force, external force F1 to the piston A. Definitely, pistons move outward. All other pistons, these pistons, piston B, C, D, they move outward. So this indicates the external pressure transmitted in all other pistons, which is remains constant. There is a external, the same external pressure. Whatever the pressure is created at point A, the same pressure is created at point B, at point C, and at point D. See here, all inward, all other pistons outward. This indicates the external pressure transmitted in all other pistons, which is constant. Therefore, the pressure created at the valve at the piston A is F1 by A1, which is P, which is remains constant. Whatever the forces, forces are F2, F3, F4 have to be applied on the valves. Forces are exerted. Forces are exerted by the liquid. Forces are exerted by the fluid on B, C, D respectively and remains constant. So definitely each piston is acted upon by the same pressure. Each piston is acted upon by the same pressure as that applied on the piston A. Whatever the pressure exerted by the point A, the same pressure is exerted by this liquid at the points B, C, D and respectively. Therefore, can I write here? Copy the things. Therefore, you can conclude that force is proportional to area. Therefore, F1 by A1 is equal to F2 by A2 is equal to F3 by A3 is equal to F4 by A4 is equal to constant. Therefore, Pascal law is proved. The external pressure is created at the piston A, which is same as the pressure exerted by the liquid at points B, C and D respectively. So hence the Pascal law is proved. That is only the concept. Whatever the pressure exerted by a fluid at any part of the fluid, which is transmitted equally at all the parts of the fluid and which remains constant. Whatever the external pressure is created at point A by compressing the piston A with a force F1, therefore F1 by A1 is equal to pressure, P is created. Whatever the pressure created at point A, which is equal to the pressure exerted by the liquid molecules, water molecules on the pistons B, C and D respectively, and such that the pressure remains constant. The best example which are worked, the devices which are working on the Pascal law, one is called hydraulic lift, another one is called hydraulic brake. Let us consider a vessel containing water. Where A, B, C and D respectively, these are the pistons fitted with the pistons. So F1 is the where the A1, A2, A3, A4 are the cross sectional areas of the different openings. Let F1 be the force, external force acting on the piston A. The area of the cross section of the piston A is A1. Therefore, there is a pressure is exerted, pressure is acting on the fluid. Pressure is acting on the fluid externally. That is P. The same pressure which is transferred to the water molecules to move the pistons B, C and D. The same amount of pressure is exerted by the water molecules on the pistons B, C and D respectively and remains same. Okay, this is about the Pascal law.